Yo, yo, YouTube! What's crack-a-lack-a jack-a smackin'? It's Waffle Man for video! If you know the NBA and you know me, you know I'm a Knicks fan. And, you know, yesterday it went down last night. I mean, I had to make this video, man. You guys know, a three-team trade between the Cavaliers, the Thunder, and the Knicks, where six players were traded between the teams. So, you know, this was a huge trade, man. A big trade last night. Probably the biggest trade of the season, probably? I don't know. I don't remember any trades that happened this season other than, you know, Josh Smith going to the Rockets. But that was a waiver and a picked up waiver. So that doesn't count as a trade. But this trade actually, you know, three teams between three big teams. And, you know, this trade was really crazy, man. I mean, first of all, Dion Waiters goes to the Thunder. J.R. Smith and Iman Shumpert from the Knicks go to the Cavaliers. And then Alex Kirk, Lou Amundson, and Lance Thomas go to the Knicks. And the Knicks also are trying to get the first round draft pick from the Cavs in 2019. So, yeah. I mean, you know, this trade is crazy, man. I mean, first of all, the pick is a 2015 first round pick. You know, but that's going to Cleveland. So, you know, the Cavs are going to get this pick if it falls outside the top 18 this year, or if it falls outside the top 15 in 2016 or 17. So, with this trade, let's talk about each team and the winners and the losers. Honestly, you know, I'm a Knicks fan. I'm not going to try to sound biased or anything, but in this trade, the Cavaliers and the Thunder won. And in some part of way, the Knicks also won in this trade. Let me explain why. So, the Thunder, you know, when you look at the Thunder's roster, who was their shooting guard before? I mean, Anthony Morrow, Jeremy Lamb, those are some, I guess, decent to good shooting guards, but those are not starting shooting guards. Now, when you got a guy like Dion Waiters, you know, Dion Waiters is still young. He's 23 years old, he's 6'4", you know, he has a good body mass, and, you know, he's a shooting guard. He knows how to score and put the ball in the hole. Not saying that Anthony Morrow can't shoot or Jeremy Lamb can't score or whatnot, but now you got a guy like Dion Waiters who's, you know, he's gonna do what he's gonna do. You know, he was that guy in Cleveland that was supposed to be, you know, part of the team with Kyrie and Dion. You know, it was gonna be Kyrie, Dion, and LeBron, or Kyrie, Andrew Wiggins, and LeBron. But, you know, Dion was always there before. He was always the guy that was there back in the days with him and Kyrie. He used to be, you know, he had some talent. He's still trying to develop, so, you know, he's not like James Harden. I don't think he's going to be as great as James Harden, but he's definitely going to be a good guy for the Thunder, man. The Thunder got a good trade from this. I mean, who did the Thunder even trade? Lance Thomas for Dion Waiters? I'll take that any day for the Thunder. I mean, the Thunder just upgraded one of their positions again. Somehow, someway, the Thunder always get some type of scoop to get a good player. I mean, I think I remember when they had Caron Butler and Derek Fisher somewhat. The Thunder had some steals before. I remember they almost had a chance to get Iman Shumpert. And man, if they had gotten Iman Shumpert in this trade, whoo! Can you imagine a backcourt with Russell Westbrook and Iman Shumpert and how hard it would be to score on them and the defense the Thunder would have in the backcourt? I mean, goddamn. But, you know, the Thunder did a great job with this trade. So let's move on to the Cavaliers. Cavaliers, honestly, a lot of people are saying the Cavaliers didn't do good for this trade because they traded Dion Waiters for Iman Shumpert, who has had a dislocated shoulder this season, and J.R. Smith, who's, you know, you guys know J.R. Smith is erratic. You know, he's not the best scorer. He's not the greatest of all shooters. He's kind of a knucklehead in a chuck. You know, a lot of people think this, but you got to take this into perspective. Excuse me. But the Knicks system has been predicated on taking a lot of shots. And, you know, the offense has been more about shooting. And J.R. Smith, you know, since New York has never had a point guard to run the offense, J.R. Smith has had to make his own shots coming off the bench. You know, there's nobody to pass it to, so he's going to have to shoot the ball anyway. So, of course, he's going to take a lot of shots. And he's, you know, he's basically the Carmelo off the bench. He has to take a lot of shots. There's nobody on the offense to take those shots. You know, there's no point guard to distribute the ball to get him make open shots. I mean, now in the Cavaliers, you got Kyrie Irving, you got LeBron James. You know, he's going to get open for these shots now. And I believe he's going to be coming off the bench because he's always a bench player. I think they would rather start Iman Shumpert because in a lineup with Kyrie Irving, LeBron James, and Kevin Love, You don't need J.R. Smith in that lineup, in that starting lineup, man. I think Anderson Varejao's out for the season, which sucks. But, you know, they could do something with this team, man. I mean, the Cavs just got deeper. I mean, off the bench, they already have J.R. Smith now. What do they have? Mike Miller, Sean Marion. You know, they also got James Jones, Brandon Haywood, A.J. Price. I mean, that's a pretty solid bench, man. Hey, they also used to have Tristan Thompson coming off the bench, but I believe, I'm not sure if he's starting now because I think Anderson Varejao's out for the season. But, hey, man, that team, yo, Cavaliers, watch out for the Cavaliers. I mean, they got two, I think, a solid person in Iman Shumpert and a decent guy in J.R. Smith. Because, you know, if J.R. Smith gets the rock to his hands and, you know, he gets open shots, he'll make them. He doesn't have to chuck anymore. He doesn't have to, you know, create shots on his own. He has a chance to do that. And now let's talk about the Knicks real quick. A lot of people think the Knicks lost in this trade, but honestly, what the hell do you want us to do? Honestly, the team's not working. We have no chemistry. We have no offense, no defense. Iman Shumpert's been injured a couple of times this season. J.R. Smith's been erratic, as you know. No point guard to run the offense. No one's understanding the triangle. No one can pick up the concept. And when you look at our roster, I mean, Bayani's going to come off the books. Amar'e Stoudemire's going to come off the books this offseason. We have Tim Hardaway Jr., who's young, still on his rookie contract. Shane Larkin, who's still young too. You know, Pablo Prigioni's kind of getting old, but I think he's also off the books this season. And everybody we got from the trade is also has non-guaranteed contracts. So this offseason, the Knicks will have $30 million in cap space, man. Over $30 million, actually. We might just have, I think we're just going to have Carmelo Anthony, Tim Hardaway Jr., and Cle Anthony Early. That's crazy, man. That's, and look, you know, LaMarcus Aldridge is going to be a free agent, even though he said he might go back to Portland. Marcus Saul, Kawhi Leonard, who knows? We could get somebody, we could land somebody good, man. I mean, hey, listen, believe in Phil Jackson. That's all we got to say. Believe in Phil Jackson. He's making these trades, and honestly, we also have a first round pick, so we have the worst record in the fucking NBA, man. I mean, what? How better can it get? I mean, we're gonna probably get at least a top 5 pick, I assume. Hopefully, the first pick in the NBA draft. But you know what I'm saying? I mean, listen, man. $30 million cap space. You know, Carmelo's been battling knee issues, leg problems. Honestly, the best thing to happen next is if Carmelo were to sit out for the season, because then he'd be ready for the next season, because the season's over, man. There's no fucking way we're going to win. There's no fucking way we're going to win an NBA title this season, man. I don't even think we're going to make the playoffs, man. We have 5 fucking wins, man. 5 fucking wins, and look at our schedule next. This is a fucking murder. Man, listen, Carmelo, sit your ass down, man. Wait till next season. Phil Jackson, make some shit happen. Actually, the other best thing that could happen is if we could trade Amar'e Stoudemire and Andrea Bargnani for something decent. Maybe some picks even. Who knows? I mean, yo, it's still plenty of time left. It's not February yet. It's not the All-Star break. But yo, I'm just saying, man. Believe in Phil Jackson. But anyways, YouTube, give me your thoughts on the trade. Hit 'em up. Peace.